Welcome to UGC EPG Pathshala. Today we will cover a topic on application of remote sensing in urban studies. Under this application area, we will cover the introduction, urban planners main requirements, levels of urban planning, remote sensing applications for urban planning, land use land cover mapping, urban land use suitability analysis through eigenvector method and method of least square with the examples environmental sensitivity analysis, urban growth, urban sprawl analysis, urban infrastructure and utility mapping, urban hydrology, effective traffic management, solid waste management, and cadastral mapping. The introduction. Rapid urbanization and resulting growth of cities is a global phenomenon and India is no exception. Urbanization can be defined as an index of transformation from traditional rural economies to modern industrial one. It is inevitable and has been both one of the principal manifestation as well as an engine of change. It is desirable for human development. The most accepted method to handle urban problems worldwide include the use of collective intelligence and good ability to predict what will happen in future by studying the past records and make progress in public activities for the sake of human environment and overall development. In recent years, urban remote sensing has become a useful tool for urban planning and urban ecological research. Remote sensing for urban can be defined as the measurement of surface radiance and properties connected to the land cover and land use in cities. Today, Earth observation system provides geocoded data and provide an opportunity to collect relevant information for urban and peri-urban environments at various spatial, spectral, temporal scales. Remote sensing technology can be used to evaluate the physical composition of urban areas like commercial, residential or mixed land use, green spaces and other open spaces. Urban remote sensing provides spatial information associated with social indicators to explain the interrelations between ecological conditions and socio-spatial developments. It offers opportunity to improve and to structure the information about the planning process. Remote sensing and geographical information to modern remote sensing technology includes both aerial and satellite based system that allow us to easily collect physical data with speed and on repetitive basis. This technology along with the geographical information system helps us to analyze the data spatially and offers many possibilities to generate various options like modeling and thereby optimize the whole planning process. Therefore, it is necessary for an urban planner or policymaker to incorporate remote sensing technology with urban planning and management. The trend of using remotely sensed data for urban studies started with the first generation satellite sensors such as Landsat, MSS, and was followed by the use of second generation satellite sensors such as Landsat Thematic Mapper, Landsat ETM Plus and SPOT. The data from IRS P6 satellite with LIS-4 mono and multispectral sensor having 5.8 meter pixel resolution was to intensive use for urban studies. Along with IRS P6 resource set, IRS 1D pan data also having 5.8 meter spatial resolution, cartosat 1 with stereo capabilities and 2.5 meter resolution, cartosat 2 with 1 meter resolution, ICONES with 4 meter spectral and 1 meter panchromatic mode, QuickBard with 61 centimeter spatial resolution, etc. sensors provide new technology for urban applications. Apart from cartographic applications, the imageries provide cadastral level information up to 1:5000 scales. Remote sensing applications may lead to innovation in urban planning in various ways. Thematic map generation using visual interpretation techniques, GIS techniques for the integration of thematic maps for urban sprawl analysis and urban land use category analysis. A special framework in GIS for prospective and development plans. Urban land suitability analysis. Computation of composite functionality in indices for various amenities such as medical, education, recreation, etc., land records calculation for urban development for capacity building of a region. Urban remote sensing is extremely useful for change detection analysis and site selection for specific facilities such as hotels, hospitals, industries, schools, etc. Urban planners' main requirements. Apart from topographic maps, planners should also take into consideration the remotely sensed data products to provide them good information on existing land use and their periodic updating and monitoring. Also, the same data along with the appropriate techniques can further be used to study urban sprawl and trend of urban growth, urban and update and monitor the existing data using repetitive coverage, survey city centers, study the transportation system of the city and its important aspects both in static and dynamic mode, slum detection and its monitoring and updating, site suitability analysis along with the calculation of catchment areas, study open and vacant spaces in the city, study physical aspects of urban environment, population estimates and urban morphology. Many studies suggest that at metropolitan regional scale, images with low spatial resolution are actually more useful than high spatial resolution images, while higher resolution images provide too many details for the level of generalization which may be appropriate for decision making at regional scale. Remote sensing application for urban planning. Land use, land cover mapping. The land is one of the prime land resource. The term land use refers to how the land is being used by human beings, while land cover refers to biophysical material found on the land. Urban land use and land cover are widely used in variety of application including residential, industrial, commercial site selection, population estimation, tax assessment, zoning regulations, etc. Land use land cover change can be consequence of urban population growth and urban sprawl. Both urban population growth and urban sprawl along with the industrial development can lead to unplanned use or misuse of the land, including the conversion of usable land into a wasteland. Therefore, urban land use, land cover mapping and environmental monitoring has been the main focus of urban planners, scientists and geographers all over the world. It helps in encroachment of urban problems, even of very small magnitude. Thus, various techniques have been applied for mapping urban land use, land cover. According to Sen Gupta and Venkatachalam, the changes in land use land cover pattern over a time period control the pasture of land, the controls the pressure on land. The urban development is complex and is so dynamic that it requires an immediate perspective planning of cities and towns. Proper planning and monitoring of land are essential for land stability, land sustainability. It is a prerequisite to collect timely and accurate information on the existing land use land cover pattern and its spatial distribution for proper planning, utilization and formulation of policies and programs and to prepare micro and macro development plans. Remote sensing provides cost effective solutions to city planners for both macro and micro level planning of land use, land cover. that further induce urban environmental management. Various data sets are integrated into GIS for the preparation of homogeneous composite land development units, with further help to identify the problem areas and to suggest conservation measures. One of the widely used data format for extracting the information from an image is the false color composite. Information is extracted from such images by three methods, namely image interpretation, spectral analysis of image, and data integration. Image characteristics and visual interpretation techniques discussed by Prasad and Sina in 2002 has been summarized in the table 1. Urban land suitability analysis. One of the classic problem in decision making or multi-parameter analysis is the determination of the relative importance of each parameter with respect to the others. This problem requires human judgment supplemented by mathematical tools. Since all the land parameters are not equal and they have a different role to play, they have been given weights as per their relative importance with respect to suitability assessment. There are number of methods to deal such problems. One of the most widely accepted method is SETI's analytic hierarchy process. In this process, scaling of weight for each parameter is done by constructing a pairwise comparison matrix of parameters whose entries indicate the strength with which one element dominates over another and vice versa. As a consequence, an importance matrix is generated by a group of experts, the value of which is based on a scale of importance intensities. Importance level has to be assigned based on discussion with the experts, such as town planning officials. Once generated, importance matrix is to be analyzed, which can be done using two methods, which are eigenvector method and least square method, for the final assessment of weightages and to nullify the biasness during the weightage assessment. These two methods, eigenvector method, the input of the method is the pairwise comparison matrix of n parameters prepared on the basis of SETI's scaling ratio on the order of n by n. Method of least square, it is another method of determining the weights in the weighted least square method proposed by Chu et al. In this method, the constant optimization problem is formulated and is then solved for the weightage vector W. For example, environmental sensitivity analysis given by Dr. Pathan in 2006 explained land use suitability analysis using the above mentioned method by calculating environmental sensitivity. For environmental sensitivity analysis, the data on air quality, groundwater quality, and surface water quality has been collected for 31 stations well distributed throughout the study area. They plotted these data, and surface analysis was carried out using tin analysis technique. From the surface analysis, they classified each parameter into three ranges and assigned a rank depending upon sensitivity of each parameter to the environment. Indices are generated by multiplying individual category ranks. Higher the index value, lower the quality, as shown in table. Integrating all three qualities in GIS, environmental sensitivity has been calculated by multiplying each quality index with each other. The index value is further classified into three categories, high, medium, and low, to represent environmental sensitivity. Urban growth, urban sprawl analysis. unprecedented population growth and unplanned development activities can lead to urbanization with lack of infrastructure facilities. This can have serious implication on the resource base of the region. Urbanization can take place in a radial direction around a well-established city of linearly along the highways. This dispersed development along the highways or surrounding the city and in rural countryside is often referred as sprawl. It can directly influence the land use, land cover changes. A geographic information system and remote sensing technology coupled with the collateral data can be done cost effective and efficiently to analyze the sprawl pattern for different spatial and temporal resolution of the remotely sensed data. This analysis can help in proper infrastructure planning. However, remote sensing and GIS with the image processing and classification can detect, map and analyze the physical expressions and patterns of sprawl on landscapes. Ultimately, the power of sprawl management resides with local municipal authorities that vary considerably in terms of fill and ability to address sprawl issues. Mona Lisa Mishra in 2011 discussed the urban sprawl of Bhubaneswar city from 1930 to 2005. The map in figure 4 and figure 5 depict details of physical growth of the city and the direction of growth. It has been found that during 1930 to 1956, the construction of city was started and many urban facilities were provided apart from large scale construction of residential quarters, so that the population growth is 4 times less than urban area growth. There is a total absence of provision of areas for a number of urban activities such as industrial, institutional, etc., which were not invoiced. During 1956 to 68, the population growth rate is 4 times the urban area growth, as during this period, employee of various departments came to reside in residential quarters, construction for the government employees. During 1968-74, the population growth and urban area growth are proportional. During 1974-81, the population growth rate has doubled compared to urban area growth. From 1981 onwards, even though the population growth is proportional to urban area growth, the areal growth is constantly increasing, whereas the population growth is constantly decreasing. The growth during 1885 to 1990. The growth during 1985 to 1990 is more in outer periphery zone, which is 7.5 kilometers to 10.5 kilometers from 1997-2005, showed tremendous rise in the built up from agriculture area, vegetation and open spaces. The city has its center at its core areas. Although the city initially evolved in rectangular shape on a grid iron pattern from the center, now it is growing largely towards north, northeast and southeast direction along the main transport routes. Urban infrastructure and utility mapping. Public services such as potable water for domestic use, educational institutes, recreational sites, power plants, transportation and waste disposal sites, etc., are some of the urban infrastructure and utility services. A large volume of data is required to an urban planner, both at pre-planning and implementation stage, to ascertain the status of the available facility and also to determine the actual or projected demand for the same. Remote sensing provides accurate, timely, orderly and reliable information respectively for urban planning and management. Whereas at the scale of 1:10,000 and larger, aerial photography provides spatial distribution of most of the urban infrastructure facilities, while the panchromatic data of SPOT and IRS-1C, IRS-1D offers better capabilities of mapping and analyzing the urban transport network, effluent discharge zone, and urban greenery. Urban infrastructure facilities can be mapped easily as seen in Figure 6, where these facilities are mapped for a satellite town of Bagru near Jaipur. Urban hydrology. Civil and hydrologic engineers and urban planners constantly require up-to-date information about urban hydrology. In India, urban agglomerations are facing at least 4 hydrological problems, which are the accumulation of sufficient volume of water for domestic and industrial use. Second is urban water pollution and quality. Third is flood control. Fourth is disposal of urban storm water runoff. Cities face problem of water insufficiency for domestic and industrial purposes, poor water quality, and inadequate storm water runoff. However, rainfall runoff cannot directly be calculated using remote sensing techniques. Rather, remote sensing can generally provide source of input data or can be an aid of estimating equation coefficient and model parameters. Remotely sensing technology include 2 measurements for mapping urban hydrology. They are impervious surface area and floodplain delineation. Remote sensing techniques can also be applied to obtain information pertaining to surface water quality, soil, drainage, land use, groundwater, and slope of the catchment or watersheds. Watersheds parameters considered to carry runoff and water estimation studies. For example, remote sensing technology was used to deal the metro water supply problem of Madras. The geographical extent of floodplain can be identified using multispectral data coupled with digital terrain model derived from terrestrial surveying, LIDAR or IFSAR. Effective traffic management. The transportation network is the most basic and important infrastructure unit of an urban area. It provides connectivity within and between urban centers and allow movement of people, goods and traffic. Transport planners often use remote sensor data to update transportation network maps, evaluate existing road and rail conditions, study urban traffic pattern at choke points such as tunnels, bridges, shopping malls and airports, and conduct parking studies. Transport network of different size can be very well mapped in satellite images as shown in Figure 8. Radar remote sensing data provides effective transportation network management. While using high resolution iconous data, one can easily see roads of width up to 3 meters or more. Such data can be used to facilitate the identification of roads that are needed to be widened to ease congestion. Solid waste management. Solid waste management is a potential nightmare for any country and its growing population. This is mainly because of inadequate, unacceptable organizational and financial capabilities of local urban governments. In this context, good solid waste management needs to separate waste streams as biodegradable, non-degradable, and recyclable. It is one of the most acceptable strategy for solid waste management. The next problem would be where to dispose it. Selecting a right disposal site is not an easy task. A geospatial database generated using remote sensing and GIS techniques on satellite data can be used to help to solve the problem. Regular efforts are required to reclaim the abandoned landfills sites and to identify suitable new sanitary landfill sites using appropriate methodology as shown in figure 10. In benefits from GIS based modeling for municipal solid waste management, discussed methodology to optimize the waste collection and transportation system based on geospatial technology. Similar study of optimization of waste bin collection and transport system has been performed in the municipality of Nikaia, Athens, Greece, where standard GIS and network analysis have been performed for the reallocation of waste bin and for the route optimization of the vehicles in terms of distance and time traveled via GIS routing. Spatial analysis for solid waste management. Output of the following scenarios were closely examined and were finally compared with the empirical routing. Spatial distribution of waste bins and their capacities in municipality area, it is, as shown in figure 11. Relocation of bins and new sectorization as per the requirement assessment results, that's shown in figure 12. Network analysis for optimal waste collection routes, as shown in figure 13. Integrating remote sensing data with GIS can aid in identification of potential waste disposal sites. This can be done using IRS LIS4 and PEN data with 5.8 meter resolution and ASTER data of 15 meter resolution. Path optimization can be performed using network analysis model in GIS environment for selecting the suitable solid waste dumping site. Cadastral mapping. A cadaster is one of the country's basic registers. It represents individual unit of land ownership and parcels and areas separated from them. It is a methodology arranged public inventory of data concerning property within a certain country, properties within a certain county or district based on survey of their boundaries. In developing countries, being slow and expensive process, cadastral mapping and cadastral surveys are considered as one of the major limitations of economic development. Yet most of the authorities agree that they are essential for economic development and environmental management of the country. High resolution satellite imagery of less than a meter resolution and aerial photographs provides highly accurate data at 1:4000 or even higher scale for the purpose of cadastral mapping and other development activities. This technology facilitates the georeferencing of the manually prepared cadastral maps as well as mapping of any other ground features with 1x1 meter resolution. Estimating population. Knowing how many people live within a specific geographical extent for administrative unit is very powerful information. In fact, some have suggested that the global effect of increased population density and ecosystem land cover conversion may be much more significant than those arising from climate changes. Estimation of population can be performed at the local, regional, and national level based on dwelling units of individual counts, which require nominal spatial resolution of 0.25 to 5 meter. Urbanized land area measurement often refers to as size of settlement. Estimates of land use, land cover classification with the availability of sufficient accurate in situ data for the calibration of remote sensing models, remote sensing technique may provide population estimates that approach the accuracy of traditional census method. In many instances, remote sensing method provide more accurate results as compared to ground-based methods. Many researchers have demonstrated the remote sensing and GIS technology for count individual dwelling units for estimating population like Lo, Holz, Heck, etc. Another popular population estimation technique is to use level 1 or level 3 land use information. This approach assumes that the land use in an urban area is closely related with population density. In this method, an empirical value is calculated for the population density for each land use by field survey or census data. They can measure the total area for each land use category. They estimate the total population for that category. I hope you enjoyed the lecture. Thank you.